Hey everyone, this is JTB.
And this is Bogowski.
And welcome back to The Run. You clicked on this video, so you saw the thumbnail, so you know what run you're watching. And you know the title. So there we go.
So and you know who's talking in it.
Yeah, this is chapter 3. It's all on the thumbnail now, you know? Improving the video quality in every way. So this fight is one example of where I want to get a little bit of, I want to kind of pad my combo here on this dude. This right here might look cheap. It's actually extremely difficult to do this, you know? So everyone knows. It's not as easy as it looks, just jumping and pressing B all those times. But I do want money there. The reason I chose to do it on the black captain guy instead of the white one is because the white commandos have a pretty good chance of dropping yellows anyway, whereas the captain guys have a very, very high tendency of dropping blues. So I want to use my combo on the captain guy to make him give me money, because they still have a base essence assigned to them. So white commando at the end actually blocked my shurikens. It actually looks really cool. Sometimes they just hold their hand up and like block it with their forearm. It looks pretty cool. Obviously he killed my combo though, so he had to die.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But you also wanted to run back to get that essence before it dissolved. You don't want to get
exactly.
Absorbed in doing some kind of fight and then forget about your high combo essence across the screen.
Yeah, I mean, that's very easy to do as well, because as I said, the enemies all have a base essence assigned to them, even if they sometimes drop blues. So, the captain guys more often than not will drop blues. Rocket launcher guys will drop blues. Cat fiends, like, often drop blues. But they still have, like, a default amount of essence that they will drop, and the commandos is still 100. So if you're killing them with a combo above 20, it's minimum 300 that you're going to get instead of either 100, or if it's a blue they drop, you'll get nothing.
That's good that you can get over the 50 on this guy.
Yep.
And, you said it's not, or I don't know if you were kidding or not, because it's not just hard jumping and pressing B, but anything you do, it might be harder than you think,
for us regular
people.
I guess.
So I didn't know how to take that or how.
Well, the jumping B bit was me being, sarcastic. But like, keeping your combo going, like coming down with the helm splitter to break the captain's guard. That's me forgetting how to play the game.
You're running all around.
Yeah.
Well, see, you focus on fighting so much that
I forget the little things, where to go.
And what to do.
That fight was a good example. Keeping your combo going. You don't want to come down on like with nothing when there's a captain guy underneath you, because they're going to try and grab you. But you also don't want to come down and block, because if you block an attack, that kills your combo. And then, you're not. I mean, you could get a 20 combo back on that captain guy and make the time bonus and still get money. But it's going to be a 20-hit combo, not a 50-hit combo. So you're going to lose points on your combo. Not a lot, but you will lose like 10 to 20 points on the combo. But it's the money that you'll lose out on, which is the big deal. That Black Captain guy would have been 600 essence when killed with a combo above 50. Whereas if I'd have killed him with a combo above 20, he would have been half that. So it does make a pretty big difference. This fight right here is worse without ETs, but there's honestly not that much in it. Unless you get that pattern there, pretty much, like, you're not making the time bonus. Your Flying Swallow has to kill that first guy, otherwise it's just, that's it. You're not gonna get the time limit.
And they're right there, like you said. He usually gives you the blue, the captain guys do. Even at full health, it's always like, well, you had to be below or almost to the end of your health bar to guarantee that. But that's, I don't think that's true. Especially at the very beginning of the chapters and stuff, I think they may know.
It's just enemy dependent, I think. Like, certain enemies, say, just have, say, captain guys, just, I've never really brute force tested it, but I would say, just simply, more often than not, they will drop blues versus yellow. Whereas, when you're at low health, every enemy has that kind of, that bigger likelihood of dropping a blue for you instead.
Right.
Some enemies drop little ones, the white commandos, they only drop tiny blue orbs. The brown imps, more often than not, if they drop health, it'll be the small blues, whereas, the captain guys, cat fiends, rocket dudes, they all drop the big blue orbs. So normally you would just ET through this. Because I think Alice just had to go for a second. But yeah, normally you would just ET through this. But again, we're not using ETs or UTs, so you can just kind of shoot them. You can just do XYY, really, with the Dragon Sword there, it'd work. But I just thought it'd be kind of fun to just, switch it up and use the bow for a change.
Yeah,
Obviously, these guys you have to kill with the bow. One thing to note with these, though, because you want more points, you know, make like shoot what each of them wants, and then when they get to the end and that timer actually pops up, then you can kill both of them. As you can see, I got 880 points there. If I'd have waited for both of them to get to the end and then shot them, I would have got way less points on that. It's only, it would have only been like a few hundred points, but, you know, it's all relative, I guess, depending on how you're playing for score. If you're going to play for score with no UTs, you know, a few hundred points is actually a big difference here.
Well, I mean, I think you adding to the saying it's a karma run, you know, and a no UT run, it adds a little extra level of the game that versus just, oh, I'm just going to not do any UTs.
Yeah, I mean, this versus a karma run score is going to be a joke, you know, because you don't use UTs. So that captain guy real quick is, again, a good example. I think his time limit was 6 seconds. And if you just forward Y Fiend Sealer, I got 330 like extra points from him. So that would, I would have needed to have gotten a 33 hit combo to get that amount of points out of combos on him. And there's no way I would have got a 33 hit combo in 6 seconds. I'm pretty sure that's literally impossible. So that was a good example of, you know, him just kill him super fast, even though ideally you'd want his yellow, but then if you go over the time limit, you've lost 10,000 points on the time bonus.
You know, also it's going to be interesting to see if you get Master Ninja ranking on every chapter. You know, does making all the time limits, fighting all the fights, getting all the end of chapter bonuses get you to Master Ninja ranking without doing a single UT?
Post in the comments. Let us know, because I know the answer to that question. Because I'm far ahead in the run. I know the answer, but I'm curious. Yeah, like, let us know in the comments what you think. I might even put a poll up for that. Like, do you think it's possible to get Master Ninja without doing any UTs?
Well, you know, in your hard run, you didn't get Master Ninja in Chapter 1.
Yeah.
So, just kind of a little suspense for everybody. We'll see how it goes in this one.
I'm wondering if combo points would be enough, though, because as I said, the point requirements in general are, at least in my opinion, I say they're quite low for what you need to get. To, you know, to actually get Master Ninja rank, like that, they are pretty generous in terms of like how, like few points you need, I guess, to actually get that rank.
Right.
So this fight coming up is actually kind of tricky. There's a couple of ways you can go about it. Normally, I think the no look attack is like super well known now. But you can't do that, obviously, because we're not doing UTs. Thinking though, it might have been better to just shoot them off screen. Shoot one, because these guys still count as kills, even if you kill them, like, before the timer shows up, so you could actually do that, maybe, now that I think about it. But I opted for just haste, straight slash there. I dropped my smoke bomb, but I dropped it way too early. I was kind of expecting these guys to actually be there, kind of, straight away, but I think that's because I'm used to, like, killing those guys with the UT and them dying immediately. So I should have just waited a second, because if I'd have dropped my smoke bomb a little bit later, I could have just, like, forward wide, on landing wide, fiend sealed and killed them both, and then just forward YY the commando guy that shows up.
I just want to say, your movement to get to that scarab right there is so good.
And I almost fall off there.
For granted. Well, that right there, you knew how to directional jump and everything, you know, when you needed to and everything. And also, you not absorbing...
Well, I left some essence
there. Do an ET. I mean, you know, to do an ET by mistake is still very awesome.
It's tricky. Like there's been two instances so far in this run, not in this chapter, but in the run so far, where like I have done an on landing UT just out of just habit, and I'm like, oh crap, like you know, I have to restart.
Right.
Because it's just kind of instinct. So there, I was gonna have fun with him, but then I realized I forgot to buy the Izuna drop.
So. Just in air and jump XY with the lunar doesn't, you have to have the...
You need the scroll, yeah.
Yeah, the scroll, okay, yeah. Okay. For the dragon sword, or so if you buy it with the dragon sword, do you have to buy the Izuna drop, or does it come with the level 2 dragon
sword? Well, your dragon sword, the dragon sword has to be level 2 to Izuna drop, and you need the scroll. Right. So if you do it without it, you'll just get Blade of Neridzi every time. So for Dynamo, like speed is the name of the game here because, you know, he's worth a lot of points. Each second here is worth 1,666 points. So just go through him with Windmill Slash into Violent Gale, which is a string I cannot recommend enough that people learn how to do. It is tricky. It's by no means something you'll pick up overnight, but once you get really comfortable with that string, like to be able to roll through anything and hit and start like offense doing that, it's super handy to be able to do that on like, you know, any given situation.
It's funny how you say overnight. I was going to say, or 15 years. I mean, you know.
It's hard. It's hard, man. Yeah, like, I hardly see anybody do windmill slash kind of just in regular play. Or, like, aside from, like, specific encounters. Like, Dynamo, I think, is an obvious one because you can windmill slash through his grab. But I think, you know, you can come down with an on-landing with windmill slash. You can do on-landing windmill slash, which basically turns your on-landing invulnerable, but that's something I use that on Hydra Cubus. Spoilers, but I use that on Hydra Cubus in chapter 5, you know, to keep my combo going. And it's something that's really good against like imps or cat fiends, you know, enemies that love to harass you as you land. Just do on landing windmill slash, and you know, you'll hit them right through their attack.
You know, it's interesting, even on this run right here, the use of smoke bombs are just effective no matter what you're doing, where it's for karma or to keep your hits up, or you know, so he doesn't hit you or block you out of it. That smoke bomb confuses him, so yeah, you can keep your combo going on that. Sorry.
Yeah, I wish they were in NG2, but I get why they're not in that game.
Well, you said it the best. You know, they were so good, they took him out.
Yep. Free mod idea for anyone. You know, like, add a smoke bomb UT. I know I mentioned this ages ago. Add a smoke bomb UT to Ninja Gaiden 2. Where, you know, if anyone's played Ratchet and Clank, it's a reference to that, where, like, you know, a disco ball pops up and the ninjas just start dancing so you can hit them for free. I would pay money to see that in Ninja Gaiden 2. That'd be so funny.
Guilty? Anybody guilty?
That's a pretty demanding mod, so I don't know how anyone would go about doing that.
Oh, okay.
But anyway, yeah, we hope you enjoyed this one, guys. That's it for Chapter 3. And yeah, we'll see you in Chapter 4, which for once is actually not a nightmare on this run. It was actually quite fun.
Oh, nice.
Which makes a change. So yeah, we'll see you guys in Chapter 4. Take care.
We'll see you guys.